Circuit switched network is defined as an example for circuit switched network. In this diagram, you can see there are four switches connected through the physical links, and each link contains three channels. Here N is equal to 3. Also, there are two end devices, A and M. Here A is a sender and M is a receiver. And there is a path from A to M via switch 1, 4 and 3. Let us next see how data communication happen in circuit switched network. There are three phases. First one is setup phase, second data transfer phase, third one is teardown phase. In the first phase, the connection is set up from the sender to receiver. That means the complete path is decided and all the resources in that path is dedicated for that particular communication. Hence, a sender would like to initiate a communication with the receiver. A path is decided and throughout the path, all the resources are dedicated for that particular communication. That is connection setup. Second phase is data transfer phase. In this phase, whatever the data to be transmitted will be done. In the third phase, once all the data is transferred, the connection will be teared down. That means there will be disconnection of the particular communication once all the data is transferred to the receiver. The total delay in circuit switched network is calculated as shown in the diagram. Connection setup, that is a request of a connection from A to B, will be transmitted through the path. As an acknowledgement, you can see there is a connection confirmation from B to A through the switches. And next is data transfer. At last, connection teardown. Hence, total delay is equal to connection setup time, data transfer plus the time to disconnect. In packet switched network, there is no resource reservation. Resources are allocated on demand. In packet switched networks, there are two types: datagrams network and virtual circuit network. In datagrams network, the packets are transmitted based on the available free channels. And also bandwidth should be available for each packet. Messages are divided into packets because of the size. As the complete message cannot be accumulated by the channel, the messages should be divided into packets. There are no dedicated path for any communication. Whichever path is free and bandwidth available, the resources are allocated then and there and forwarded. After receiving the different packets, the packets are rearranged. Because of variation in the delay of each packet, it will be received in different delays. Hence, the packets are rearranged in the receiver. In this example network, you can see source A and destination X. There are 1, 2, 3, 4 packets in this. And the routers in this network are R1, R2, R3 and R4. Here each node is called as a router because of its functionality. So the routers are maintaining routing table which is having information to route the packet to the next node. In datagrams network, the routing table contains two parts. First one is destination address. Second is the output port through which the data will be forwarded to the next node. Here is the example of a routing table in datagrams network. This is how we calculate the total delay: 3t plus 3 tau plus w1 plus w2. Transmission time, propagation delay plus waiting time will be added. Virtual circuit network is a combination of datagrams network and circuit switched network. There are five characteristics to note. Virtual circuit has setup and teardown phase as in circuit switch network. Resources can be allocated during the setup phase as in a circuit switch network or on demand. Each packet contains a local address called as VCI, that is virtual circuit identifier. All the packets follow the same path established during the connection. Usually, virtual circuit network is implemented in data link layer, circuit switch network is implemented in physical layer, datagram network is implemented in network layer. In this example, you can see the routing table in virtual circuit connection. The routing table contains two main parts, that is incoming and outgoing. In incoming, you can see port number and VCI number, and outgoing also port and VCI number. Let us take the first example in the entry, that is 1, 14, 3 and 22. This means that if the incoming port is 1 with the virtual circuit identifier 14, then it should be forwarded to the port number 3 and the VCI should be updated to 22. You can see in the example, the data which is coming in the port number 1, that is entry in the switch with the 14 as the VCI, that is updated to 22 in the outgoing port 3 according to the first example entry. Let us consider now the second example in the table, that is 1, 77, 2 and 41. Consider the second data packet which is having the entry of VCI as 77. VCI means it is the local address. The full form of VCI is virtual circuit identifier. So this data with the 77 as VCI entry, which is incoming in the port number 1, where should we forward this? That is based on the outgoing entry in the table. With 1 as incoming port number and 77 as VCI, it should be forwarded to the outgoing port 2 and the VCI should be updated as 41. Further, you have more examples to understand this concept better. This diagram shows how the data is transferred from source to destination. This diagram shows how the connection setup request is done in virtual circuit network. This diagram shows how the receiver acknowledges the setup request. Here, small a, b, c, d, e are the steps in acknowledgement, and switch 1, switch 2, switch 3 are the switches included in this communication. In this diagram, we can calculate the total delay of the virtual circuit communication. We have time for setup and then transmission and at last teardown. Also, you can observe that here there are two switches included in this communication. A and B are source and destination respectively.